people might, it might not actually be clear enough for some people if they don't necessarily have experience with the context you're referring to. Okay, so here's what I want to point out. I might have to stop here. So there are, the reason I wanted to show you the other tasks first is to show that not every single one of these tasks is sort of like, I think some people might find this a boring task. But we just spent, my time's up, we just spent 5 minutes talking about this task. There were lots of interesting comments, lots of opinions. I mean, the juice that you get out of this dry task is really quite extraordinary. And the extent to which you can generate a good discussion with a fairly dry task is part of the point of the project. And so I'll end there and let you ask questions.
Questions?
So you said there are 30 or so people who are logging on and vetting these?
Yes. Yeah.
At some point, will they be sort of available? Or are they a known group?
I guess we have to ask. We haven't asked them yet whether they want to be.
Okay.
But they're not a secret group. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I think we haven't thought that far. I mean, part of the point of the project is anybody could potentially become one of these people.
So they could log in.
The idea is you could register. You could maybe at some point be promoted to a submitter. So also what will be happening in January is we'll be building into the site a commentary function where people can rate tasks, write comments on them. Maybe from those comments we'll find, somebody who, wow, this person really seems to be good and on the ball and have some really interesting comments. Let's make them a reviewer. And so we'll sort of be inviting people to join, and hopefully eventually it becomes a community which is not managed by a person, but which is self, like a sort of social network of some sort.
And can I throw one more in? Just what's the relationship of these tasks to the assessments that are now being developed?
I hope a strong relationship.
Yeah.
I mean, part of what we hope to do is to set some sort of standard of what it means to assess a standard. The assessment consortia are certainly interested in this project. Oh, and by the way, we have a national advisory board which has representation from both assessment consortia.
I was going to say, there's some software developed by Paul Denning, University of Auckland, called PeerWise, which is a social networking model for developing multiple choice questions.
Uh-huh.
And sort of, the really good questions sort of evolve naturally by peer evaluation.
Right.
And there might be some features of that software that you can exploit for this.
Yeah, no, that would be very interesting.
Does it have an equation editor?
Sorry?
Has it got an equation editor?
An equation editor.
Yeah, they do, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so by the way, the tasks are entered on this side. At the moment, people have to essentially type them in LaTeX, or at least to get the math, you use a LaTeX language. It uses a program and a JavaScript that interprets that. We're hoping to eventually develop a more WYSIWYG type editor that's more transparent to the normal user.
Are there any tasks which are more open-ended kind of problems, or is it?
Yes. Yep. I mean, that one that I showed you, that we were briefly looking at about the video camera, I think is a fairly open-ended task. I will say that at the moment we're focusing on open-ended tasks are wonderful. They're obviously what everybody loves. They're rich, they're deep and engaging, and so on. If we only produce those tasks, the assessment consortium will completely ignore us because they're not to a certain extent, I think they might be interested in some of those, but you know that the assessments are going to have lots of short tasks. So if we don't have a sense of quality in design of multiple choice short tasks, then those tasks will be written by, teachers in sweatshops in basements in New York City or something like that. I mean, which is the current way in which assessments are written in the U.S. is this sort of mysterious, invisible process whereby publishing companies employ armies of who knows to sort of churn out tons of tasks. And so it would be nice to have a different sense of the quality of task design for short tasks. So there is a bit of an emphasis on the shorter tasks at the moment for that reason.
More questions?
About 70?
Say that again.
The problem.
The answer to that.
Oh.
I thought that was in live metrics.
Well, certainly under the influence of the Common Core, it's very funny to say that. Certainly under the influence of the Common Core, they are creeping towards them because there's lots of metric in the Common Core standards. I don't think they dislike it, they just don't use it. They just have a mixed, they have a mixed sort of usage.
The metric system has been in standards for a long time, it hasn't made it into everyday usage.
Right.
Because if you're training kids to be physicists or whatever, maybe, if that's what they're thinking of doing, engineers, they need to know the metric system.
Other questions?
How did you get involved in this?
It's 4 minutes before 3:30, and I don't know.
Okay.
I'll tell you tonight over a glass of wine.
Okay, deal.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.